Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge. And today in this video, we are going to learn how to add filters in already created Spring Boot project. So here we can see I have already created one Spring Boot project. And in this project, I have created multiple layers: controller layer, service layer, entity and repository layer. So first I will start our application and check if it is working or not. So first I will run this project, run as Java application. And here inside controller we can see I have created two controller classes. One is message controller, that is just returning one string value, and second is student controller. And student controller contains two API. One is list get all students and second is to add student. So here we can see our application has started at port number 8080. So I will go to browser and here I will just open Swagger. So swaggerui.html. So here we can see inside student controller there is two APIs and inside message controller there is one API. So first I will execute message controller API, try it out and click on execute. So here we are getting the response: welcome to Gain Java Knowledge. So here we can see our API is working fine. So now we are going to learn how to implement filters in our already created Spring Boot application and why we need filters in our Spring Boot. A filter is an object that is used to intercept the HTTP request and responses of your application by using filters, and we can operate two operations at two instances. These are the two operations that we can perform using filters: before sending the request to the controller, or second, before sending a response to the client. Okay, let's create one filter in our already created Spring Boot application. So first here I will create one package, new class, and here I will just enter the package name dot filter. And here student filter. So this is the class student filter, and here what we need to do, here we need to implement interface that is filter. So here we need to use Java extort servlet filter. So this is a Java extort servlet filter, and here what we need to do, we need to add unimplemented methods also here. So here we have added one method, that is doFilter, and at class level we need to define annotation, that is @component, so our Spring application will understand and will create the bean for this class. Now here I will just add the loggers. So I will go to message controller and will just copy this line of code from here and go to my controller filter class. So first I will refresh, and here where is our filter package? This is our student filter class. Just copy student filter, and here I will add logger dot info inside to filter method. So here we can print any logs. And next what we need to do, we need to call chain dot do filter method. That is default method. So here we have created one filter, and now I will stop my application and restart our application, and we'll check how this filter will perform. So now I will just click run as Java application. And here on console, we can see the logs. So here we can see our application has started at port number 8080. Now I will clear all the logs and go to browser. And here I will just execute message controller API. So this API has executed and we are getting the response, welcome to gain Java knowledge. Now I will go to console and check the logs. So here we can see first our student controller student filter class was executed. After that our API message controller inside get message method was executed. So like this we can create any number of filter classes in our project. So with the help of this filter class we can print few more information like this. Here I will print few more logs, logger.info, and here I can print. So I will just copy it and so here I am going to print local port number, server name, and also going to print method name, request URI, and the servlet path. So here what I will do, I will create HTTP servlet request object, servlet request, that is HTTP servlet request. So here what we need to do, here we need to do typecasting. So here I will just paste it here, and request will become HTTP servlet request object. So from servlet request object I will get the method name dot get method. So like this we can print any information before controller method execution. So now I will stop the server and start our application again. So here we can see our application has started at port number 8080. Now I will clear the logs and will execute any API. So here I will go and this time I will execute our student controller get student API. So after executing this API we will check the logs. So now our application, our API has executed and we are getting response with 200 status code. Now we'll go to logs and here we can see inside student filter first we are getting local port, server name, method name, request URI, and the servlet path. After that our student controller method was executed. So like this we can create any number of filters in our filter package or in our Spring Boot project. But if we have multiple filters, then to execute multiple filters in order we need to use one more annotation at class level in our filter class, that is @order annotation we need to use. So our filter will be executed in orders. So let's create one more filter. I will just copy it and we'll paste it here, and this filter will be our message filter. We can give any name. So here we can see I have created one more filter, that is message filter. Remove all the logs from here and just change the name, copy it, paste it, message filter inside do filter. So here we can see we have created two filters. Now I will just stop our application and run it again. Now here we can see our application has started at port number 8080. Now I will clear the logs and will execute any API. So here I will just call get student API, and API executed successfully. Now I will go to console and check the logs. So here we can see first our message filter was executed. After that student filter was executed. And after that local port, server name, all details that we have added inside our filter. And after that our controller method was executed. So like this we can create any number of filters. And if you want to define orders, first we want to execute student filter, after that message filter. For this we need to define one more annotation, that is @order. So what I will do, I will go to our student filter and here I will just define @order annotation, and here I will just define the order. So first it will execute our order filter, that is student filter class, and second will be executed message filter. So second will be message filter. So now I will stop the application and start it again, and then we will check on the console. Now our student filter will execute first, after that our message filter will execute, and after message filter our controller class will execute. So here our application has started. Now I will just clear the logs, and now I am going to execute getStudentAPI, and this API was executed successfully. Now go to console, and here we can see first our student filter was executed and we gather all the information. After that second order to message filter was executed, and after message filter our student controller class was executed. So like this we can create any number of filter classes and can define the orders for filter classes. So this is the way we can manage execution order of filters. And there is one more scenario. If we want to restrict our filter for some specific URLs, means we want to execute our filter class for some specific URL or some specific APIs. For that we need to create one more class, that is filter configuration class. So here we can see we have two filters. The one is message filter and second is student filter. Now the requirement is there, we want to execute message filter only for message controller API. When we are going to execute message controller API, then only message filter should execute. For this what we need to do, we need to create one more class. Okay, let's create one more class, that is filter config class. So here I need to create one more package, that is new class, and here I will define the package name demo.config, and class name we can define filter configuration. And here at class level we need to define annotation, that is @configuration. So Spring Boot will understand and will read all the configuration from here. @configuration annotation. And here we need to create the bean. So here what I will do, I will just create one method, public filter register bean. Filter registration bean, and here we need to define our message filter class. So here what we are going, registration bean, now inside this method I will just create filter registration bean object, filter registration bean, and message filter is the class, message filter registration bean is equal to new filter registration. So after creating this method, here we need to set filter for the message filter. So what I will do, here I will just copy registration bean and we'll need to set the filter. So here I will just call set filter method, and inside this method we need to pass the object for message filter. मैसेज फिल्टर। सो आफ्टर एडिंग दिस फिल्टर इन साइड अवर बीन, वट वी नीड टू डू नाउ, हेयर वी नीड टू एड यूआरएल पैटर्न फॉर आवर रजिस्ट्रेशन बीन। सो वी नीड टू डिफाइन द रजिस्ट्रेशन बीन यूआरएल। सो हेयर वट आई विल कॉल एड यूआरएल पैटर्न। सो नाउ आवर मैसेज फिल्टर विल एग्जीक्यूट ओनली फॉर दिस यूआरएल पैटर्न इफ आवर एपीआई कंटेन्स स्लैश मैसेज, देन ओनली इट विल एग्जीक्यूट मैसेज फिल्टर। सो आफ्टर दैट आई नीड टू रिटर्न सेम। सो लाइक दिस वी कैन क्रिएट एनी नंबर ऑफ रजिस्ट्रेशन बीन्स इन साइड अवर मेथड इन साइड अवर दिस क्लास फिल्टर कॉन्फिग्रेशन। सो हेयर आई हैव जस्ट क्रिएटेड वन बीन एंड हेयर आई हैव डिफाइंड इफ अवर यू आर एल पैटर्न कंटेन स्लैश मैसेज इन एपीआई यू आर एल पाथ, देन ओनली अवर मैसेज फिल्टर विल एग्जीक्यूट। इफ वी आर कॉलिंग स्टूडेंट कंट्रोलर एपीआई, देन अवर मैसेज फिल्टर विल नॉट एग्जीक्यूट। नाउ टेस्ट अवर एपीआई अगेन। सो हेयर आई विल स्टॉप माई एप्लीकेशन एंड रीस्टार्ट द सर्वर। सो हेयर वी हैव डिफाइंड इफ अवर एपीआई कंटेन्स स्लैश मैसेज इन यू आर एल पैटर्न, देन ओनली अवर मैसेज फिल्टर विल एग्जीक्यूट। इट मीन्स फॉर आवर स्टूडेंट कंट्रोलर नाउ ओनली वन फिल्टर विल एग्जीक्यूट। सो हेयर फर्स्ट आई विल टेस्ट अवर स्टूडेंट एपीआई एंड हेयर वी नो अवर स्टूडेंट एपीआई डज नॉट कंटेन स्लैश मैसेज, देन इट मीन्स अवर मैसेज फिल्टर विल नॉट एग्जीक्यूट। सो हेयर आई विल एग्जीक्यूट दिस। नाउ वी नीड टू चेक अवर कंसोल लॉग्स। सो हेयर वी कैन सी अवर स्टूडेंट फिल्टर वॉज एग्जीक्यूटेड एंड मैसेज फिल्टर वॉज ऑल्सो एग्जीक्यूटेड। सो बट दैट शुड नॉट प्रिंट हेयर। सो वी नीड टू चेक अवर कोड एंड आई थिंक आई हैव नॉट रिमूव्ड एट द रेट ऑर्डर एनोटेशन। सो फर्स्ट आई नीड टू रिमूव दिस एंड नाउ गो टू स्टूडेंट फिल्टर एंड नीड टू रिमूव दिस ऑर्डर एनोटेशन। सो नाउ आई विल स्टॉप माई सर्वर अगेन एंड री स्टार्ट दी सर्वर। सो हेयर वट आई हैव डिफाइंड अवर इन साइड अवर फिल्टर कॉन्फिग्रेशन क्लास, इफ अवर यू आर एल विल कंटेन स्लैश मैसेज, देन ओनली अवर मैसेज फिल्टर विल प्रिंट द लॉग्स। सो हेयर आई विल गो टू कंसोल, क्लियर द डाटा। नाउ विल एग्जीक्यूट अवर गेट स्टूडेंट एपीआई। वेन वी विल एग्जीक्यूट गेट स्टूडेंट एपीआई, देन ओनली स्टूडेंट फिल्टर शुड एग्जीक्यूट। सो नाउ आई विल गो टू कंसोल एंड हेयर वी कैन सी ओनली स्टूडेंट फिल्टर लॉग्स वर प्रिंटेड एंड अवर मैसेज फिल्टर वॉज नॉट एग्जीक्यूटेड। नाउ आई विल क्लियर द लॉग्स अगेन एंड नाउ आई विल गो टू ब्राउजर बैक ऑन अवर स्वैगर एंड नाउ आई विल कॉल अवर मैसेज कंट्रोलर एपीआई। वेन आई विल एग्जीक्यूट दिस एपीआई, देन इट शुड प्रिंट लॉग्स फॉर बोथ फिल्टर। नाउ इट शुड प्रिंट लॉग्स इन बोथ फिल्टर्स, मीन्स स्टूडेंट फिल्टर लॉग्स विल ऑल्सो प्रिंटेड एंड मैसेज फिल्टर लॉग्स शुड ऑल्सो बी प्रिंटेड। सो नाउ आई विल गो टू माई कंसोल एंड चेक द लॉग्स। सो हेयर वी कैन सी आवर स्टूडेंट फिल्टर वॉज एग्जीक्यूटेड एंड अवर मैसेज फिल्टर वॉज ऑल्सो एग्जीक्यूटेड। सो हेयर अवर बोथ फिल्टर वर एग्जीक्यूटेड। सो लाइक दिस वी कैन क्रिएट एनी नंबर ऑफ फिल्टर्स इन अवर ऑलरेडी क्रिएटेड प्रोजेक्ट एंड ऑल्सो अप्लाई द रेस्ट्रिक्शंस ऑन फिल्टर क्लासेस। ओके, थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो।